that it's an exciting journey ahead. So without further ado, let me introduce you our speaker for this morning's webinar session. Ms. Ave is a computer science graduate, magna cum laude, content creator, seasoned public speaker and mentor, former application analyst, technical community manager, and social media specialist. She is currently the technical support specialist and cases coach of Fortech Inc. She is also an Angel Hack ambassador and mentor of Impact Hackathon. She shares her knowledge with various universities and tech companies about the fundamentals of web development, web design, information security, database systems, and automation. She is an advocate for social participation and has been engaging with tech communities to share her knowledge and experiences in the tech industry. Ms. Abe aspires to be a computer science professor and cybersecurity analyst. Once again, our resource speaker for this morning, Ms. Atina Acha Abe.
Ayan, thank you for that wonderful introduction, Angela, and thank you for JPCS, ayan, City College of Calapan chapter for having me on your very first series titled The Future of Information Technology, Exploring Emerging Trends and Innovations. Ayan, and although we do not have our chat for today, I do highly encourage you to actively engage in our session. This will be a two-hour long session and we would be, I would be later on during our presentation. Oh, by the way, for the organizers, is it okay if I share my screen? Because I just added some little slides there. Ayan, let me know. I'll take over if it's okay. And then let me know if you can see my screen right now. Can you see it?
Yes, Pop. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Ayan, thank you. Okay. Let me also make sure. Okay, there we go. So today we're going to explore about the World Wide Web. Ayan. I was already introduced, but to add more information, I know my introduction out there a while ago was very long, but I was also a former JPCS SPU Manila Chapter President in 2018 to 2020, and then I became the former JPCS SPU Manila Chapter Core Group Member. So definitely, I'm also happy that in your chapter in College of Calapan, you guys are organizing these types of events, because one of the missions and visions of JPCS is to really help fellow students in the JPCS community to be able to learn more and be educated in the current trends of information technology and computer science. And I also heard that you guys are information system students. So, ayan. And then, although we do not have a chat, I would also, I'd like to see what you're feeling right now and your reaction so you can fully hit that reactions while we're going through this discussion. All right. So right now, you guys will be definitely be overwhelmed with a lot of information, starting with learning for 2 hours. I believe each session you'll be learning about World Wide Web. And then I also saw that you will be learning about AI, UI, UX design. So definitely a lot of information overload. But I won't be going too technical in my presentation. The goal here for these sessions is for you to be able to have an idea from the professionals and also have a much deeper understanding and appreciation of what are the current trends today. So kung nag-IS ka dahil di mo sure, sabi ng mama mo, or dahil yun din yung kinuha ng friend mo, it's okay. We're going to help you identify your career path and give you more reason why you have chosen information systems as your bachelor's degree. But I always start with my presentations with a question. So my question for you guys is, sa tingin nyo, bakit tayo gumagawa, even as students, di ba, in our programming courses? I believe we have a series of levels here. We have first year to graduating students right now. Why do you think that we create programs or applications? So since we do not have a chat, I encourage you to raise your hand. There's no wrong answers here. From the top of your head, why do you think that we create programs and applications? Ayan. Medyo naalog na yung utak natin kanina sa icebreaker, but I believe ito kahit hindi nyo i-Google, may sagot kayo dito. Ayan, and in every presentation that I do, if you do not respond right away, I can call names. So kung ayaw nyo matawag, ayan, you can freely raise your hand. We have less than 200 participants here today, and I do appreciate your time joining us. So let me know if you want to share your answer by raising your hand and unmuting your mic. Again, the question is, why do we create programs or applications? Ayan, anyone would like to answer? Yes, Apple. Thank you for raising your hand. Oh, may nakita akong nag-raise ng hand. So since we are a lot here, we can hear from 5 people. So I'll have Apple. You can go ahead and unmute your mic, please.
Ayun po. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, ma'am. For me po, some of the application that, ano ma'am, yung kinreate po ngayon is most for entertainment. Tapos some of it naman po ay for education. So para po sa akin, para po may magamit po yung tao at mas mapadali po kumbaga yung kanilang mga works. At saka po mapadali po kung paano po nila mapapadali po yung gawain. Parang ganun po.
Ayan. Thank you then, Apple. So your keywords are entertainment and educational. Ayan. Very good answer. How about Jamil? Ayan. You can go ahead and unmute your mic. And I'm also waiting for the others to raise their hands. Maybe 3 more people. Ayan.
Hello. Good morning. Can you hear me?
Yes. Loud and clear.
Okay. As someone who studies information systems, usually po yung aming program focuses on the study of how technology and the information are used within the organization. So why do we create programs? I think as information systems students, we create programs to support the operations of an organization and to solve their problems like proficiency and effectiveness in various professional settings of the institution or the organization.
Ayan, very good answer, Jamil. So I can see that on your keyword, you said purpose of why we create programs is because it depends on the type of purpose of the organizations, which is very true. Ayan, very good. How about the others? Let's wait for 3 more people before we continue. Ayan, through your active participation, this would also help me navigate kung paano natin patatakbuhin ang ating discussion for today. So you guys can have a more understanding of our topic, which is about World Wide Web. How about the others? At least 3 more people before I continue. Ayan. Or I can see a lot of names here, so hindi kayo pwede mag-anonymous ngayon. Ayan. Anybody else? No wrong answers? And if you have the same answer, it's okay. Yes, Alfred. Thank you. You can go ahead and unmute your mic.
Mama, I think it is what the people needs po. Parang kung mag-create po tayo ng application, mas convenient po sa kanila na gamitin yung application na yan. Like for example po is for shopping, for transactions, pwede po nilang gamitin yung application para mas mapadali po nila yung ano, yung mga bagay-bagay.
Ayan. Thank you, Alfred. So based on your answer, there's definitely a need. And you also said para mapadali. So there's efficiency as to why there's a need for us to create programs or applications. Very good. How about the others? Maybe 2 or 1 more would like to share their answer. So we have entertainment, education, organization, and efficiency when it comes to our need. Ayan. How about Jelame? Thank you. Go ahead and unmute your mic.
Just like Mr. Alfred said po na mapapadali po yung ating ating ano po, dahil halimbawa po ngayon po yung sa online ano, online virtual ano po meeting po, napapadali po yung ating ano na hindi na po need natin pumunta ng CCC na para lang po sa meeting. Napapadali po lahat ng ano, katulad po nung sa ating pag-aaral ng ano online class po. Lalo na po kasi kulang yung room ng ano CCC, kaya hindi po ano na hindi po lahat ay pwede mag ano F2F.
Ayan, thank you, Jelome. So, based on your answer, the reason why we need to create applications and programs is for convenience. Lalo na ngayon, post-pandemic, dati we are required to go to school, to have our meetings, to have our online lessons. But right now, with technology and through this application like MS Teams, we're able to gather kahit nasa iba't ibang lugar tayo. Ngayon, I'm here based in San Diego, California. It's currently evening here, ayan, but with technology, I'm still able to share and talk with you guys about this. So, ayan, thank you, Jelome. Anybody else before we proceed? Last one. Ayan. Let me see, anybody would like, ayan, very good, Jenna. Ayan, napaka-active naman ng students. Okay, go ahead and unmute your mic.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning. For me, we create programs or applications so we could develop systems that would help it, that would help businesses to streamline their processes.
Ayan, very good answer. Streamline their processes. So with a web, with programs and applications, this also helps business venture to be able to provide their services and products more efficiently through their customers. Ayan, thank you for that. Okay, now we will proceed. And I hope throughout our discussion, you would still retain the same level of engagement that you have. So here is our like roadmap for today on bakit nga ba natin or why do we need to learn about World Wide Web? Eh, atcha, I can just, pwede ko lang yan i-Google, pwede ko lang yan i-chat GPT. I want to learn about AI UX design. I want to learn about web development kasi yun talaga yung interest ko. Of course, may hugot, di ba? Hindi na dapat binabalikan ng nakaraan. Pero para sa atin, para mas naiintindihan natin kung bakit nauso ang AI UX design is of course to understand where it all happened. And World Wide Web is a part of that. Ito lang yung mga bagay in the field of IT na kailangan talagang binabalikan ng nakaraan para mas na-appreciate natin kung bakit natin ginagawa yung mga bagay na ginagawa natin as information system students and in the future as IS professionals. And tulad ng sabi nyo, creating applications, creating programs, ito ay one of the reasons that these types of inventions or innovations happen is because of the World Wide Web. And I'm going to share with you why and how it was created. We're going back through history. I'm going to show a brief history of when it started to happen, the benefits of World Wide Web, the challenges. So, yeah, and what are the different challenges and how can we combat them to be able to not experience it as a challenge, but as a strength and as like a benefit na din with the use of World Wide Web. And of course, lastly, the trends. Now that we later on we're going to go through the history and what World Wide Web is in the at present in 2023, now we're going to more understand kung saan natin siya pwede mas magamit. Depende din on the field that you want in the future. So as students, whenever tinuturuan tayo ng teachers natin na about programming, hello world, ayan, learning about HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, at kung ano man ang programming languages na tinuturo sa inyo, dahil sobrang fast-paced ng curriculum natin sa Pilipinas, when I was a computer science student, I definitely understand yung nararanasan niyo right now na parang ang dami naming inaaral sa IS, ganito programming language, ganyan, information system. Natututunan ko nga, pero na-challenge ako or nahihirapan ako kung bakit, kung paano ko siya napapagawa, bakit ko siya napapagawa, di ba? There's a meme, you're seeing a meme right now that says, my code works, but how? So, iba pa din kapag naiintindihan natin kung bakit natin ito ginagawa at paano at para saan. That's why I asked you a while ago why there's a need to create programs and applications. And based on your answers, you definitely know the reason why as information system students. Ayan, Here, we're going to start with the history of World Wide Web. Don't worry, it would not be boring. I won't go into every detail kasi ang need lang natin dito malaman how it all started. As you can see, diba, even yung mga magulang natin, mga lolo at lola natin are now using the web or what we call the World Wide Web. So, at this day and age, we have a lot of information to process, especially as students. Paano ba tayo nakakapag-catch up sa current trends today? Is of course through the webinars that the JPCS officers have organized for you. And also, kasi ang daming, sobrang daming resources on the internet, but how are we going to be able to process each and every one of them? At the same time, alam niyo yan, as IS students, marami ding information systems. But going back in 1980s, the main concern on that era was how are they going to make it compatible? So there was a European organization before called CERN. And this is one of my main resources for this discussion. There are a European organization for nuclear networks. During those time in the year 1980s kasi, there's a lot of laboratories and scientists that are especially processing and maintaining information, and they have these separate information systems that they use. Although they have their own separate computers, they have their networks, pero hindi pa talaga sila totally connected with one another. So that was the challenge. And kanina back on your icebreaker, the person who invented World Wide Web was Sir Tim Berners-Lee. And Tim Berners-Lee at that time, he was working at CERN as an independent contractor. So pag independent contractor ka, you don't directly work for the company, you're just like a consultant. So he, at that time, while nung nagtatrabaho siya sa CERN, he saw the situation and thought of a way kung paano niya papadaliin yung workflow ng mga scientists doon when it comes to their information systems. So during those times, maraming need for scientists and laboratories to be able to connect all of their information systems into one connection. So another thing here is that minsan some people or most people can correlate internet and web development as one entity. But they are not exactly the same. To give you a differentiation of it, ayan, internet is not equals to World Wide Web. The internet is a global network of computers that can communicate with each other. So back in the 60s, diba, we call ARPANET, or what we call Advanced Research Projects Agency, they funded a research to create a network for academic and scientific purposes. So back in the days, a lot of scientists, diba, they needed networks, and the ARPANET was created. Although during that time, konti lang yung access ng ARPANET. Then there comes in World Wide Web. Ito yung application na ginagamit using the application of using the internet in the web. So the web is now turned into a network that can be accessed by the public in the present time. Ayan. So here's an image of Sir Tim Berners-Lee. We call him Sir kasi he was knighted by the Queen. Kaya ang name niya talaga in complete is Sir Tim Berners-Lee. And he is the inventor of the World Wide Web. Ayan, you remember kanina what HTML means? The URL and the HTTP. Can anyone give an answer what the HTTP means? Ayan. You know HTML, but what does HTTP mean? Anyone? Like, quick answer. One person only. What does HTTP mean? Kahit mag-unmute kayo, no need to raise your hand. Anybody? Baka nag-google pa. Yes, Jelami. I saw that.
Hypertext transfer protocol.
Very good. Yes, hypertext transfer protocol. So, Sir Tim Berners-Lee thought of creating the World Wide Web because of his experience and observation while working at CERN as a fellow. So, it all started as a project in 1980. And then by 1989, CERN was the largest internet node in Europe. And in 1989, the first proposal of the World Wide Web was created. This inspiration of Sir Tim Berners-Lee, it came from a book that he read in his old parents' house in London. It was like if I'm not mistaken, a Victorian book that nabasa niya doon, may nabasa sa inquire within upon everything. So from that phrase, inquire within upon everything, naisip niya na gumawa ng program called Inquire, which is a predecessor of the World Wide Web. Here, ayan, ito yung picture ng kanyang proposal of the Inquire. Ito yung, Inquire was the first software project of Sir Tim Berners-Lee at CERN. And then he created a proposal for the World Wide Web. Given the situation, di ba, I asked you a while ago, bakit nga ba tayo gumagawa ng programs and application? Of course, when we create something, there has to be a reason why. We don't just create for the sake of it. Because we create, there's a purpose for it. It won't, something that we create or yung mga bagay na ginagawa natin, it would be useless if we don't put value into it. The reason why as information system professionals in the future, you would be tasked to create by your organization of a product or a service that would be beneficial and would be able to help solve a problem. And the problem that he was experiencing, as I mentioned to you guys, is there's no connection of networks of all the computer systems or information systems that the scientists were working with. So he thought of the World Wide Web, also came from the Inquire program that he created to be able to connect everything. His main purpose was for the World Wide Web to give universal access to large universe set of information or documents. Ayan. And ito yung pinakaunang web server. Dito niya ginawa ang World Wide Web. This is called the Next Computer, and if you can see on the lower right corner of that image is his proposal for that information management system. Going back to our timeline here, in 1990, na-formalized na ang World Wide Web in November in 1990. It became an information management proposal for the World Wide Web, and we have our first web browser. In 1991, back in the day, kasi that was only created for CERN, for that organization, but then yung goal talaga is to make it accessible for all people. That's why it became open source. Ayan. According to Forbes, there are 1.13 billion websites around the world right now. And every day, ayan, if you can imagine right now, every day people create less than 300 million. Ayan, 300 million websites every day. So imagine the large amount of websites being created every day and the number of servers. It all started with just this computer kanina na nakikita natin going back. Ayan, but imagine right now at less than 300 million websites are being created. So what are your thoughts about that, guys? Imagining that there are this amount of websites being created, what do you think is the effect in 2023 compared to what you learned right now so far about how the World Wide Web at bakit nagawa ang World Wide Web and the first web browser? Imagining this data right here that there are currently at present 1.13 billion websites, what do you think is our situation right now? And anyone would like to raise their hand or unmute? Yes, Apple.
Probably po, most people will rely on internet or websites po.
Ayan, thank you. Definitely, all of us heavily rely on internet and websites. Thank you, Apple. How about the others? At least we can hear from four more people. Ayan. Kung ayaw niyong matawag. Ayan. So, medyo may na-flash lang ako dun saglit. Ayan! Anybody else? Four more people. I'm scrolling right now. If you're... Ayan. Would like to share. My question again, if you would like me to repeat it, is what do you think right now is our current state or situation based on what you heard, that there are 1.3 billion websites at present that are created. Ayan. And there are less than 300 million, I repeat, million websites being created every day. Pagising mo sa umaga, may 300 million websites within the next 24 hours. Ayan. Is it okay for me to hear from Marinel M. De Guzman? Ayan, if you can unmute your mic.
Look. Ma'am, good morning. I'm good morning po.
Hi. Ayan.
Para po sa akin na yung po ano. Sa internet din po. Yung pwede ka po through communication. Mag ano po siya yung andun po yung mga update or na pwede natin gamitin sa at ano, gamitin sa at.
Ayan. Medyo choppy ka, Marinel, pero narinig ko si sagot mo. Ayan, thank you. Ayan. Okay, thank you, Marinel. Ayun, based on her answer, totoo nga naman, no, at this year, nagkaroon tayo ng note. There's a term called Marites. Diba, Mari, anong latest? And with websites, it helps us to stay up to date with the latest news, trends, chismis, ayan. At imagine niyo what more kung marami talagang websites na na-create, especially with the advent of social media, napakadaming information na na-spoon-feed for us. And based on Apple's answer, we heavily rely on the internet, which is definitely true. It can be on any other reason. Sabi nga kanina, kaya gumagawa ng programs and applications is for entertainment and education. So, any other answers? Any other thoughts or point of view? Imagining that ganito kadami ang ginagawang websites ngayon. Anyone? Ayan? Would like to volunteer? Last three before we proceed. Yes, Carl. Ayan. You can go ahead and unmute your mic. I'm not sure if you're already speaking, but you can go ahead and unmute your mic. Ayan. Ayan, I can see your hand again. Ayan. Okay.
Hindi lang po na palitan yung name. So my insights po, if the developer continues to create billion of thousands of websites po, I think the continuous demand po sa mga tao din po ay nag-i-increase. Kasi po yung purpose po nung pag-create po ng websites ay para ma-support po yung needs ng tao sa bawat sa araw-araw since na-streamline ng web ng mga websites application yung ating pang-araw-araw na buhay or yung mga process na kailangan nating gawin po.
Ayan, very good answer. May I know your name, please?
I am Lenny May Manalo po.
Ayan, thank you, Lenny May. Very good answer. Definitely, based on the data that we have right now, according to Forbes, the more websites that we have, which also equates to the number of demand that the users would be needing and the developers also would be needing to produce. That's definitely true. And definitely to streamline our processes. Hindi mo yan chinat GPT, ha? Ayan. Thank you. Napaka very good answer. Anybody else? Two more people can like to give their answer. As you can see, based on our three volunteers, they definitely gave three different point of views of the effect of having multiple websites being created every day. The World Wide Web has been created for over 30 years old na siya. Ayan. Anybody else? Before I choose a name. Ayan. Let me see. No raised hands yet. Yes, Jamil.
Okay, sa akin po siguro ay yung environmental effect po nung mga websites na yun, because the increase of websites po ay increase din sa web traffic na that would likely to have an environmental impact dahil sa energy consumption po na related doon sa paggamit ng mga website na yun, hosting and all things po. So katulad po dito yung weather inversion po na nararanasan dito sa Metro Manila. Hindi mo po siya masabi kung ito po ba ay ash from the Taal volcano eruption or fog lang dahil sa lamig. Pero marami ding nagsasabi na due to weather or climate inversion nga po. So sa pagdami po siguro ng mga websites na nakikreate everyday, ay mas malaki din po yung environmental impact nito sa ating kapaligiran.
Ayan. Thank you. Thank you din. Ayan. Definitely, our environment is our, like, one of the main concerns when we create these types of programs or application. And a website is an evident example that it's not just only the software that we have to consider, but only the network, including both software and hardware. As you can see before, diba, on the image that I've shared with you, the next computer, isang square desktop computer lang siya. Yun yung server dati. Ngayon, servers are in multiple rooms, big machine rooms, and that would require more energy. So, and in this slide right now, there's 1.13 billion and not all of them are currently active. So there are a lot of servers that are wasting our energy and resource that could also give a big environmental impact to us. Ayan, thank you, Jamil. Anybody else before I proceed? Wala na. Okay. So, I don't know if you saw that next slide kanina, but diba, we heavily rely on the internet and we heavily rely on our search engine. What do you think, and according to Forbes, what do you think is the most visited website? You can unmute kahit marinig ko lang yung hula nyo. Ano yung tingin nyo yung pinaka-visited website? Any guess? Yes, Gabriel.
Para po sa akin, ang pinaka-visited po na website as of now po ay TikTok.
Oh, TikTok. Good answer. How about the others? So, meron na tayong vote for TikTok. Yes, Ralph. Yes, Kevin. Oh, si Ralph muna. Nakita ko yun. Ralph.
Ano po? Good morning po. ChatGPT po.
ChatGPT, thank you. How about Russell? May nakita ko isa nag-raise. Nakalimutan ko yung name niya. Yes, Russell.
Good morning, ma'am. Yan din pong ChatGPT or yung iba pa pong website na related po sa use of artificial intelligence.
Ayan, very good. So, meron na tayong one vote for TikTok, dalawa for ChatGPT. Nakita ko nag-raise ng hand si Jellamy bago kay Trisha. Ayan, Jellamy, ano sagot mo?
Google po.
Google, ayan. Good answer. May one vote na tayo. How about Trisha?
Google din po.
Google, ayan, leading tayo na si Google at ChatGPT. How about Joy? Ayan, if nagsasalita ka, nakamute ka, Joy. Ayan, habang hinihintay natin si Joy, how about Rachie? Ayan.
Huh? Saan po is Facebook?
Facebook. Ayan, thank you, Rachie. How about Wellme?
Google din po.
Google, ayan, top na si Google. Thank you. So, meron tayong TikTok, ChatGPT, Google, Facebook. Ayan, how about you, Jamil?
Shopee,
ayan, no. Siguro may ka mag-online shopping. Ayan, thank you, Jamil. And how about last is Marinel? Ayan.
At po, YouTube po.
a YouTube. Ayan, thank you. So we have TikTok, ChatGPT, Google, Facebook, Shopee, at YouTube. But according to Forbes daw, ang pinaka-top visited website ay Google. Ayan, thank you sa mga nag-participate. Google is one of the most visited website. Ayan, according to Forbes. Tulad na sabi ng mga nanay natin, lalo na ITIS students tayo, kaka-computer mo yan. But they don't understand, or the older generations don't understand the benefit of the World Wide Web and why we use it. We use it for other different purposes. Tulad ng sabi nyo, Google, TikTok, Facebook, ChatGPT, either educational or entertainment. So it goes both ways, diba? Ayan. Sa kaka-computer natin, nanalo ang Google. Kasi si Google ang isang mga sources natin pag meron tayong katanungan. Ayan. Very good, guys. So, in definition, World Wide Web, or what we call Web, or W3, this is built on the foundation of simply linking pages. Diba? The goal of Sir Tim Berners-Lee was to help CERN, or the European Organization for Nuclear Weapons, to interconnect each of their networks for the scientists and for their information systems to be connected to one another. Kasi diba back in the day, they would need to bring their separate computers just to be able to communicate or transfer ang kanilang mga documents. Diba we had analog and then transferred to digital, but there was still a challenge, which is to interconnect these networks and devices together. So they use hyperlinks that are referenced with URLs, or what we call uniform resource locator. And then these resources are presented in web pages or websites. And then from there, ginagawa natin ang mga web pages. Ito yung mga una natin natututunan in our introduction to computing class, which is to use HTML, CSS, and scripting languages like JavaScript. Alright, alam na namin ang nakaraanin na we know how the World Wide Web was created and who created it, but how does it really work? So it works with three things. We have hypertext, TCP, and DNS. Hypertext, this is a system of interconnected text with hyperlinks. Diba? We have HTML, and if I'm not mistaken, HTML5 is the latest version that we have. Diba? It helps those web pages that we create that have this uniform set of languages through the HTML. Ayan, hypertext. We interlink pages with one another. We have TCP, or what we call Transmission Control Protocol. The TCP, what it does is creates an online transport system. Ayan, it uses a network of IP address or internet protocol. And sinisigurado niya that data gets from one point to another. And next is DNS. Anybody know what DNS means? Review na lang yan sa inyo. What does DNS mean? If you had your introduction to networking class, who knows what DNS means? Yes, Alexandra.
Excuse po, rinig po ba ako?
Yes, loud and clear.
DNS po is a domain name system.
Very good. Yes. DNS stands for Domain Name System, and this provides a unique set of internet protocol address. Ayan, it's an identifier. And on the World Wide Web, we need these three: hypertext, transmission control protocol, and domain name system. And all of these three would enable a whole system of website to be interconnected with one another. Very good, guys. The first website, though, was created. Malapit na tayo. We're done with history. Nadaanan na natin ang nakaraan. But we're currently gradually going to the present and what is progressively happening after the invention or birth of World Wide Web. So, In 1993, the very first web browser that was created was Mosaic. And Mosaic was created to be accessible for a broader audience. Kasi World Wide Web was created specifically for CERN, and then in 1991, it became open source, and now we have Mosaic. They also have this dedication in the University of Illinois for the first web browser. Ayan. And then next, so yan yung itsura. So kung nagpo-program kayo ngayon or yung pinakaunang program nyo na HTML, tapos ganyan din yung itsura, don't worry kasi dati yung mga ginawa ganyan na ganyan din and no need to be intimidated sa mga ginagawa ngayon ng mga UI UX designer, web developer na sobrang high, ano na, advanced na. The most important thing when you create your information system is to have a solid foundation of yung fundamentals. And being able to create, but in the day this one, it has given a bigger purpose and value. So as long as you are equipped with the fundamentals of HTML, CSS, and JS, magiging madali na yung to learn other different programming languages. Ayan. And then after the birth of the web, next is, ayan, nawala. Did I create one slide? Wait, let me check. Bago may social media, meron pa. Sige, I'll just mention it. So, even before, bago pa nagkaroon ng social media, meron tayong tinatawag na .com bubble. Kasi syempre, nagkaroon na ng birth of the web, syempre, nag-emerge na siya. It became a trend. It became influential to different business venture. Diba sabi nyo nga na kaya tayo gumagawa ng mga websites is to help businesses to be able to, diba, better serve and have an online avenue for their customers to be able to access their services. And in 1995 and 2000, ayan, pinanganak na ba kayo niyan? Di ba ata? Ayan. The dot-com bubble was, yun yung term na kinoy. Kasi di ba may google.com, dot-com, ganyan. Dito, mas nag-boom siya. I think I have a diagram here, but I think I misplaced it. But there's like, it became popular during that time for online businesses. Like tulad ng sabi nyo ngayon, di ba meron tayong Shopee, ganyan. Then, doon din sila gumagawa ng platform to sell their stocks, ganyan. However, in 2000, nagkaroon ng recession. So, nalugi yung kanilang ginagawang services back in the day. So, that was the dot-com bubble era na tinatawag. Sana nandyan lang yung slide. Okay, next we have social media and web 2.0. In the screen, I don't know if you watched yung movie ni Mark Zuckerberg on how he created Facebook, but if you did, itong face mash, alin ang mas nauna, face mash or Facebook? Who can guess? Ayan. Yes, Jelami.
Face mash?
Yan, bakit? Why face mash?
Yung po, ang alam ko po kasi yan po lagi yung uso dati kaysa po doon sa Facebook.
Bakit siya?
Hindi ko sure, pero yan lang guess ko po.
Ayan, okay lang yan. Thank you. Ayan, thank you for trying. But during this time, the emergence of social media and Web 2.0, the purpose of Web 2.0 is to create user-generated content. So, di ba, the World Wide Web was created. And the purpose of that is to connect, to have a universal connection of all universal documents. Yun yung purpose dati. Siyempre, as time goes by, we innovate and we improve. And instead of just displaying and connecting these information systems together, they have created Web 2.0, which is user-generated content. So, meron na siyang user interaction with the system. Hindi lang niya dinidisplay yung information, but also it gets input from the user. That's where Face Mash by Mark Zuckerberg was created nung college student pa siya. And Web 2.0 also helped emphasize ease of use, participatory culture, and interoperability, which is nakikita niyo ginawa niyo yung face mash kung sino daw mas hotter than those photos until he created Facebook. So, mas nauna yung face mash and then Facebook. Facebook was created to a bigger audience to connect more people, not only in a country, but globally as well. Ayan. And then next, another example is we have MySpace. Sino dito nakagamit ng MySpace? May gumamit pa ba ng MySpace nung time nyo? Anybody? Do you know what MySpace is? Anyone? Wale? Okay lang yan. So, noong 2001 to 2009, the developers of MySpace, it was actually created as an accident. Ayan. And then, when they created MySpace, wala sa objectives nila is to create a customizable page for every user. Hindi napansin ng mga developers na users can customize their HTML and CSS layouts. So as you can see on the right side of the screen, the users can definitely change the backgrounds, the font style, the font color of their profiles. And yun yung mga Facebook, Yahoo Messenger Times, Tumblr, yan, MySpace was created by accident. Who knows? Malay nyo, makagawa kayo ng application on your own by accident and it would go big. Ayan, kung oo man, let me know. Ayan, so yun yung MySpace. And it also became a social media platform that also engaged user-generated content. And then, ayan, kung na-try nyo na yung marquee, paborito ko sa HTML dati, natututo ko yung marquee, yan yung gumagalaw sa header. This is a header page called Graphics for MySpace in 2006. This is an example. So, as you can see, during each and every like year or era, unti-unti nang na-i-improve ang user interface and also mas nagiging accessible na siya and collaborative because there's user there is user generated content na tinatawag. Next is mobile revolution and apps. Ano yung pinaka-phone na nagamit nyo growing up? Anybody would like to share? And kung ano man yung sagot nyo, kung ano yung unang phone, I have a second question. So, anong klaseng phone yung una nyong nagamit growing up? Bago pa yung mga Android, iPhone. Anybody would like to share? Ano yung pinakaunang phone nyo? Maliban sa toy phone, of course. Yes, Jessa. Very good. Ano yung una mong phone?
Hi, my name.
Ha?
Yung una ko pong na 3315 po.
Nokia?
Apa.
Ayan, dun sa 3315 na Nokia mo, na-access mo yung web browser? Na-access mo yung web browser nun?
Hindi po.
Hindi, ayan.
Mahirap. Hindi hirap po kasi sa signal kasi pinaglumaan pa po yun ng mother ko.
Ah, okay lang yan. Ayan, thank you, Jessa. Anybody else? So, ayan, alam nyo na yung second question ko. Si Jessa, yun daw yung una niyang phone. How about the others? Meron ba kayong isa sa mga phone nyo na first time nyo na-experience mag-browse sa web page gamit ng phone? So, nakikita nyo, unti-unti na siya nag-evolve from your computers. Yes, Jelome. Active nito, ah. Ayan. Ano yung unang mong phone? At kung nakagamit ka ng browser?
Yung ano po? Yung my phone po?
My phone. My phone is
Apo, yung my phone po na dikit and video.
Tama ba?
Parang ako.
Nakagamit ka ng browser sa my phone mo?
Na-try ko po mag-browse doon. Apo.
Kamusta naman?
Nakakamangyan po dati kasi dati po yung first time po nalaman na may ganun po.
Yes, ayan. Thank you, Jelome, for sharing your experience. Siyempre, nagsimula pa lang we had access through the web using our phone. Siyempre, interesting. At the same time, parang dahil bago siya sa atin, parang when we use the web on our phones, maliit yung screen compared to our computer, 'di ba? Dati, kung na-experience yun, 'di ba, mag-comp shop para lang makipag Facebook, maglaro ng Pet Society or kung ano man yung nilalaro niyo dati, mahirap to use the web using our phone and the font is very small. You have to zoom in. Wala pang hindi pa uso yung what do you call that in web development. Minsan na nakakalimutan ko. Pero hindi pa dati na re-resize or nag-a-adapt. There's a term for it. It starts with letter R. If you can remind me, ayan. Hindi pa uso yun nun. So you have to zoom in. Sometimes there's no zooming in on your phone to be able to navigate through the web. Ayan, wait, let me search it. O, di ba, malaking tulong ang World Wide Web. Web development. Okay. Ayun, responsive web design. Hindi pa uso yung responsive web design before on our mobile phones when the world, when the web was integrated into our mobile phones. O, diba? Thank you, World Wide Web, kasi na mental block ako saglit. Responsiveness. Hindi pa uso yung responsiveness nun. So, as you can see on these phones that I'm showing to you right now, these are one of the phones that were created in 2010. Going to the farther left, going to from the left to the right, we have the Nokia 1800, which is this one. We have Nokia X3 Touch and Type. Makikita niyo may maliit na Wikipedia symbol dyan. We have the Windows Phone here. And on the farther right, we have the Samsung Galaxy S. And these mobile devices are able to use the web back in 2010. Ayan. These application ecosystems were led by Apple and Google, and then it initially changed how we access content and services. So, di ba, as students ngayon, if nakakaya, kung kayo ay information system student na walang laptop at nasa survive niyo yung college niyo dahil meron kayong phone, malaking bagay na yon. Marami ding estudyante na nakakayanan na nila ngayon mag-program at matuto ng programming using their phones. So, the evolution of the World Wide Web has really gradually increased its accessibility and compatibility with other systems. Ayan. Next slide. Na-delete ko siguro yun. Ayan, now we have streaming and on-demand content. On the left picture, we have Netflix. Back in the day, Netflix was not generally created as a streaming platform for like online movies. Dati is siyang rental, 'di ba? Dati meron tayong Video City na nagre-rent tayo ng CD para makanood ng movie, ng latest movie. That was the initial purpose or mission ng Netflix was to have movie rentals. Ayan. So it on the left side that this is the interface of Netflix no 1997. Isa silang DVD by mail service. And on your right, in 2010, ayan na yung kanilang user interface. So that was the streaming platform before. And ito naman yung YouTube, di ba? Sabi nyo, isa sa mga, isa sa YouTube ang most visited website. And that's definitely true. In 2010, ayan yung interface ng YouTube sa left, and on the right is the interface of YouTube in 2017 where we have dark mode. Nauso na si dark mode. So, ayan. Ayan yung itsura niya before. And leading up to the present, we have IoT or Internet of Things, and we also have smart devices. Ayan, we have our wearables where on our smartwatches, we're able to track the steps that we take on our smart homes. If you have Amazon, Alexa, or Google, ayan, you are able to control yung mga certain devices nyo at home without manually having to go to that physical device and control it. But with just your phone or with just one application, you'll be able to control the whole ecosystem of your smart home. Ayan. And IoT also enables us to be able to connect all of these devices wirelessly. So as you can see, Sir Tim Berners-Lee has this good purpose of connecting information systems all together. And one of his goal is to be able to have it accessible for all people for free. And with that, in 2021, binenta niya yung source code niya. He didn't create the patent. He gave it entirely for the people to see and use on how he created World Wide Web. So in 2021, he sold it as a non-fungible token or NFT, in short, for $5.4 million. Sir Tim Berners-Lee is a huge advocate for open data and net neutrality. So, di ba, some developers, they have this, I forgot the term again. Google, help me. They have a term that starts with letter P aside from patent. And ito yung lagi ko naririnig pag umaattend ako ng event ng mga CTOs or yung may-ari ng big companies. Ayun, proprietary. They call it as proprietary. It's very confidential. They don't give it out to the public for free. It's not open source. But Tim Berners-Lee is the opposite of that. He gives his ideas and yung mga creations niya and projects open to all, or what we call open source. Ayan. Don't worry, guys. We're na sa kalahati na tayo. But before I continue, I just want to take a check-in sa inyo. Based on what you learned today, do you think using the web is good or bad? If it's good, why? If it's bad, why? Hindi pwedeng both. Pipili lang kayo. Ayan. Yes, Jelamay. Ano pa ka-active ni Jelamay? Wala bang iba dyan? Ayan, go. Sige.
Hindi po pwede both. Both po dapat ano yung
code. Oh, sige. Bakit both? Okay lang.
Ano po? Sa good, madami ka, ano po, madali ka po kasing maka-access ng mga need mong gawin or ano. Something, ano po. Tapos sa bad po, masyado pong nagiging addict sa mga website po.
Ayan. Ano ba yung mga nakaka-addict na website?
Like yung panonood po ng K-drama, sa mga laro po, ganun.
Ayan. Thank you, Jelamay. O, sino ba nakaka-relate? Sino dito nakaka-relate sa K-drama? Taas yung kamay nyo. Ayan, nakaka-addict daw. Sino yung mahilig madood ng K-drama? Relate ba kayo? Ayan. Mas nagiging bad ba siya kasi it's addicting? Walang nanonood ng K-drama, si Jelamay lang. Huli ko K-drama na napanood is Legend of the Blue Sea. Ganun katagal. Senior high school student pa ako. Tapos ayun. Wala. Ayan, nag-wow tuloy siya kasi hindi kayo nanonood ng K-drama. Ayan, anybody else? Actually, trick question yun eh. Kung sino mag-raise ng hand, siya tatawagin ko. Ayan, well, May. Very good. What's your answer to this question?
Ma'am, just like Jelamay po, is both po. Kasi why? Po, using web is good po in a way na it can give us a lot of information po and it can make our lives convenient po. Especially now na kailangan natin ng mas madali po tayong makakalap ng information through webs and mas madali po yung coverage ng pagde-disseminate ng information. And bad po siya on the other side kasi po, alam naman po natin na hindi lahat po ng nasa web is true or factual. Kaya nasa atin din po yan para kung paano tayo mag-analyze or magtingin ng informations, kung maaram tayong mag-verify ng mga factual informations po. Kasi po kung hindi is magiging victim po tayo ng mga fake news or fake informations.
Ayan. Thank you, Wilmay. Very good answer. So, always be careful when using the web, diba? It can either be good or bad. It depends then on how we use it. Tulad ng sabi ni Jelamay na di ko daw siya sa K-drama, kaya medyo hinay lang tayo din. Ayan. How about the others? Three more people before we proceed. Ayan. We're 174 here. So, let us know if you're still here and if you're learning. Ayan, syempre para makamove on tayo, we want to make sure that you are learning our topic for today. Ayan, it's just the start of our 8 series discussions. Yes, Lainey May.
Is actually good because it offers numerous benefits po sa tao, sa ating personal life and professional life. However, we should be mindful about the potential risks and challenges that may be encountered in using web po.
Ayan, very good. Thank you for that answer, Lini May. How about the others? Last one before we proceed. Yes, Apple. Paka-active. Ayan, what's your answer?
Ayan po, ma'am. Useful po talaga siya. Sa good side, ma'am, useful po siya sa mga adults. Dahil, ma'am, sila po yung nakakagamit. Sila po yung napapadali po yung mga gawain through this web nga po. At on the other side, ma'am, it is bad. Dahil po, ma'am, may mga bata po na do may mga ano nga po yung mga tawag doon, may mga limitation, ma'am, sila. Kaso, ma'am, may mga hindi po natin may iwasan na may mga bata pong tawag doon, nakakapasok, ma'am, nakakagamit ng web. So, parang yun, ma'am, namumulat lang sa kanila na parang ang paggamit ng web ay okay lang, tama lang. Tapos, hindi, ma'am, nila hindi po nalalaman nila yung risk na pwede po nilang ma-encounter when they are using web.
Yes, that is true. Thank you. Ayan. May, actually, clue ko yung bata sa picture. And definitely, nagiging bad siya concern yung for limitation and filtering. Nakita ko na nag-raise ng head si Jolene. Ayan. What's your answer before we proceed? Why is it good or bad?
Good morning po.
Hello.
For me po is good and bad po. Kasi po, good po siya kasi nagagamit po natin siya through communication po sa ibang, yung sa mga kamag-anak po natin na sa ibang lugar po, malayo. Nakakahingi po tayo ng update po gamit yung web. Tapos bad po kasi po may mga batang umaabuso na po, hindi na po nila alam na nakaka-affect na po ito sa kanilang health po. Yun lang po.
Yan. Thank you. Yes. Good when it comes to communicating with our loved ones abroad in a different place. Bad because when we are getting too addicted, it can also affect our health. Thank you for that good answer, Jolene. Ayan. Next, mag-move on na tayo. Now we're going to, but before I proceed, sabi ni Tim Berners-Lee, lahat ng sagot niyo tama. And he said in one of his World Wide Web conferences is that while the web has created opportunity, given marginalized groups a voice, and made our daily lives easier, it has also created opportunity for scammers, given a voice to those to spread hatred and made all kinds of crime easier to commit. So aside from being addicted, it being unhealthy, this also gave an avenue for bad actors to be able to take advantage of its users and to be able to create these types of crimes for their own benefit. Ayan. Very good answers, guys. Now we're going to proceed with the benefits. First and foremost is our availability of information. It's really evident with the birth of the World Wide Web that everything now is accessible from Google, YouTube, TikTok. Dati, nung bago ako graduate last year, nung nag-speech ako, nasa YouTube yung speech ko nung graduation ko eh. At pala sinabi ko, thank you YouTube University or Google University. Ngayon, TikTok University. Mas madami pa ako natututunan sa TikTok University. Ayan, lalo na yung mga na-experience ko right now, ang dami, like, kahit simpleng how to prepare for like a job interview, for example. Of course, not everything that we see, especially on TikTok, since it's a very public platform and anyone can be a creator, we also still need to fact check those informations. But there are a lot of good tips and tricks in those types of social media platforms. As you can see, benefit number one, there's availability of information. Number two, global media. Ayan. According to Deloitte, they have created a study to compare different generations. On the green bar graph here, we have Generation Z and Millennials. And the black one, meron tayong Generation X, Boomers, and Matures. Tingin ng mga older generations, mga Generation X, Boomers, and Matures, parang hindi nagiging masyadong meaningful sa kanila ang emergence of the web. Given that these types of generations are so, they're not so used to adapting to the current changes that we are currently experiencing in the present time. Hirap sila kasi dun sila mas comfortable sa nakasanayan nila. Kaya 'di ba kung obserbahan natin yung mga lolo at lola natin, hirap silang gamitin ang ating smartphones kasi hindi yung nakasanay nila. Sanay silang mga fax machine whenever they try to communicate. They're also used to yung mga telephone system or yung tinatawag nilang aparato. So, yun, dun sila nakasanay. It's hard for them to adapt and adjust to the current technology that we have right now. That's why, as you can see here, napakababa ng results or percentages from them when it comes to using our online or yung websites. Another data that Deloitte has shown here is that social media or the global media is becoming more interconnected and interdependent. Tulad ng sabi niyo, di ba, mas nakakapag-connect na tayo and communicate with other people in different types of like purposes. Like dito, we have gaming, we have people can discover new artists from different types of platforms or genre. We can access our different TV shows. Tulad ng K-drama, di ba? Minsan may mga, pag nasa ibang bansa ka, di nila kayang i-access ang K-drama. Pero dahil may web at meron tayong virtual private network, nakakapag-access na sila ng K-drama kahit it is like not allowed in their current location or country. Ayan. Number 3, we have rapid communication. Based sa mga sinabi nyo, isa sa mga keywords yung communication. With the web, you're able to communicate more. It facilitates our access and we have no barriers. Itong no barriers part na to, tulad ng sabi nyo, too much is not good. Too much can be addiction. Too much can give a bad effect in our health. So this type of benefit can differ then, can either be beneficial or detrimental due to the user experiencing it. And nung pandemic, syempre parang masyado tayong isolated, we have no one to talk to. Some of us, we have friends that we can communicate 24/7 in Messenger, play games, we have different ways of coping with what we experienced 3 years ago. But one of the ways I was able to cope was I use the web to be able to communicate with other people internationally. So I have a playlist on my YouTube channel. I don't know them. I just met them online. And one of them, her name is Pok. She taught me French, Thai, and I taught her Tagalog. Ayan. So we have four videos. And I also met Anisha. She's in the UK and tinuruan niya ako ng British lang. Siyempre, pag challenge niyo ko ngayon, that was 2 years ago, hindi na ako marunong, di ko na din natatandaan, pero dahil meron tayong World Wide Web at meron tayong YouTube, pwede kong panoorin ulit yan and I can relearn yung tinuro nila. The web is so amazing. Thank you to Tim Berners-Lee because without it, we won't be able to communicate with other people around the world. So, ayan, isa sa mga playlist ko, tinuruan nila ako mag-Thai, tinuruan ko sila mag-Tagalog, ayan siya. So that's part of the benefits. Another one is yung rapid communication. So itong nasa kikita niyo sa left side, screenshot yan ng chat, tinago ko yung pangalan niya. Pangalanan na lang natin siyang John Doe. Ayan, di ba sa IS, masyad lagi natin ginagamit si John Doe or si John De La Cruz or kung sino man. Sabi niya sa akin, ate, pwede makahingi ng title thesis proposal sa computer science, kahit idea lang. Sabi ko, sige, tapos nabit yung name niya, John Doe. Tignan mo to. So dahil napakadali na lang sa ating mag-search, napakadali na lang sa ating hanapin ang sagot sa internet or sa World Wide Web, madami ng resources. And with that, this person used her platform and used her connections to be able to get the answer. I sent her a link, and ito yung link na sinend ko sa kanya, pag-linik yan yung lilitaw. There's over 1,000 thesis titles there na pwede niyang makuha. So parang nakikita niyo ngayon, hala, at siya, pwede pala kita i-chat mamaya at para hingiin yung link para makuha ng thesis title. Yes, at the same time, I don't really encourage it in a way na we should not always be too dependent of our resources online without really trying to understand or learn that type of content that we're trying to ingest. What does it mean, Acha? It means that masyado tayong, di ba sabi niyo, masyado tayong nagiging dependent to a point na may ChatGPT, hindi na tayo natututo. Kaya itong event ay ginawa para sa inyo is para mas maintindihan niyo yung value. Ngayon, we're definitely lucky. We have this opportunity and privilege to have web, di ba? Our ancestors do not have this type of technology right now. And this post was created in 2021. Diyan ko din nakuha yung thesis idea namin. Itong list na to, these are just ideas and suggestions. It doesn't mean kung hihingin nyo man to sa akin, hindi nyo siya kukopihin lang. Kasi it's copyright. This also just gives us an idea kung ano pwede natin gawin. We create these systems to improve it, not to exactly copy it and imitate it. Kasi diba, we're trying to solve a problem. That's what Tim Berners-Lee did. Nakita niya, meron na existing existing technology, he needed to improve it. How he connected these information systems together. That's how the World Wide Web was created. In this example, I am encouraging John Doe na sige, those are the 1,000 list of thesis titles for computer science na pwede mong kunin. Pero tulad ng sabi niya, kahit idea lang, this gives you an idea. Ang dito sa list na pinili namin, we chose may isa dyan na about career decision. So yung group namin, when I was a computer science student, we created the web application called a career decision guide siya for senior high school students. Ayan. So I hope you understand yung point nitong slide na to is to encourage people not just to depend heavily on the web but also use it as a way to help them understand yung kanilang sinesearch. How about this one? So let's analyze this photo. There's a post in IT Philippines on Facebook. Yung admin screenshot niya kasi pag magpo-post ka, 'di ba, sa Facebook group, sometimes hindi siya agad magpa-publish. Kailangan mo muna i-filter ng admin. So, titingnan natin dito sabi nung admin, kay ninong estudyante to. So, tinakpan ko yung name niya. Pangalan natin siya Jane De La Cruz. Ayan, si Jane. So, sabi ni Jane, nag-request siya na how to solve this using Java. Tapos, pinicturan niya yung whiteboard nila sa school. Ayan. So, anyone, can you give me your thoughts on this one, please? Based dun sa slide na nakita nyo kanina. Anybody would like to share their thoughts? Diba, nag-share kayo, bakit good ang web, bakit hindi siya good? And now, this si Jane, as a student, ginamit niya yung web, which is okay, kasi ginamit mo yung web. But, ano yung thoughts niyo on how Jane used the web? What Jane did was to post in IT Philippines, took a photo of the whiteboard. I think assignment siguro nila to, project or quiz. Sabi niya, how to solve this using Java. Ano yung thoughts niyo? Anybody? Ayan. Yes, Apple.
Ayun, ma'am. Parang papasok na po siya doon sa sinabi ko po kanina na nagre-rely. Though, syempre, ma'am, pwede pong humingi ng tulong online. Pero, ma'am, yung humingi po ng parang mismong code na, ma'am, kasi po nakalagay po dyan, how to solve this using Java. So, parang hinihingi na niya, ma'am, yung mismong source code po. Parang it will not help her na maka-acquire, ma'am, ng knowledge kung hinihingi niya po mismo yung sagot po sa kanilang assignment. Kaya, ma'am, parang assignment para, ma'am, magkaroon siya ng another knowledge or something. Parang ganun po.
Ayan, very good answer, Apple. Sino ditong nag-a-agree sa sagot ni Apple? Totoo ba na ang ginawa ni Jane ay mag-rely? Kasi si Jane, kinamit niya yung web. Pero, nag-a-agree din ba kayo sa sinabi ni Apple? Yan, anyone? Is Jane heavily relying on using the web and not helping herself learn how to solve this flowchart using Java? Anyone? Ayan. Sino? Ayan, may nag-thumbs up. Yes, Jolame.
Hindi na po ako ano. Sang-ayon naman po sa sinabi ni Miss Apple po. Pero siguro yung itong ano, yung itong girl na nag-post dun sa ano, sa group na at ng Facebook po. Siguro po nahingi lang naman po talaga siya ng idea or tulong po sa ano, pero hindi naman po yung mismong sagot talaga yung gusto niya siguro ihingi. Kundi
tanggihin mo. Akan ka nga.
Ayan, thank you for muting that person. Yes, Jelome, you can continue. So you said you agree ka, pero you have a different point of view. So what is your point of view for Jane? Di ba si Jane yung ating example name?
Ano po? At sa ngayon po sa sinabi ni Ms. Apple, pero parang naman po siguro dito sa tinutukoy niya is yung parang gusto niya lang po magpaturo kung paano niya po, paano po i-solve. Hindi po yung mismong answer talaga mismo yung hinihingi niya. Gusto niya lang din pong humingi ng tulong sa tao po sa group na yun.
Ayan. Thank you, Jelome. Ayan. We have another person would like to give their thought. How about you, Russell?
Ma'am, para sa akin po ay pares naman pong may point si Miss Jella and si Miss Apple. At gaya nga po nung na-discuss po kanina, may positive and negative side po yan. Sa positive, yun nga po yung pwede tayong mag-seek ng help. And doon naman, isa pa pong positive doon ay yun nga po, marami pong available information na pwede tayong mag-rely sa internet or sa website. And yung downside naman po ay nakakalimutan po natin yung limitation natin at sa tingin ko po, ang nakikita ko pong negative, pinaka-negative po ngayon sa ngayong generation po dahil po sa advancement and yung development po ng ating internet or mga ng technology ay napurol po yung utak ng iba, ng ilan sa mga kabataan ngayon dahil imbis na pagganahin po natin yung practical skills, practical knowledge ay nagre-rely po tayo sa websites or sa internet na dahil naniniwala po tayo na they can provide, so bakit pa tayo mag-e-effort ng, ba't pa tayo magbibigay ng effort kung kaya naman pong ibigay ng internet yun ang mabilisan, yun lang po.
Ayan, thank you Russell. Anybody else? I believe marami kayong opinions or point of view. I think I'll just add a follow-up question. So nakita niyo mga sagot ni Apple, Jelome, and Russell na it can, yung intention ni Jane dito ay can either be good, gusto niya lang naman na humingi ng tulong, wala naman masama humingi ng tulong, we can give help. However, at the same time, they said that nagiging negative siya yung the thing or impression ni Jane when posting this kasi parang, diba, tulad nga ng sabi ni Apple, naging heavily reliant tayo. At the same time, sabi ni Jelome, baka gusto lang talaga humingi ng tulong kasi sabi, how to solve this using Java. So, it can go both ways. Based on your sa mga narinig niyong answers today, based on how Jane created this post, how do you think she can improve it para hindi maging ganun yung impression ng mga taong nakakakita nitong post? Kung ang intention talaga ni may Jane pala ditong pangalan. Hindi ko napansin. Pero itong example natin is how can we improve? Kung tayo yung nasa sitwasyon niya, how can we improve yung pag-post. Kung ang intention niya talaga is to ask for help, not heavily rely on the community's answer sa mga members ng group. Yes, Jelome.
Ayusin po yung caption niya para po malinaw. Malinaw. Yeah. Yung instead of how to solve this using Java, papalitan niya lang po ng lalagyan niya lang po ng word na help. Na help po, help me to understand yung how to solve this using Java. Ganun po.
Ayan, thank you Jelome. Meron akong inihintay na specific answer. Anyone hung na gustong mag-try? Ano pa yung pwedeng ways na
pwedeng i-improve nito, nitong nag-post, ang kanyang caption. So, improve natin niya, tulungan natin siya, yung caption. Sabi ni Jella, may lagyan ng help. Yes, Apple.
Can somebody help mo? Parang gano'n.
Pwede. Ayan. Anybody else? Yes, Wilma.
Parang ano po, can somebody give me some advice or tips po? Or tutor, ganun po.
Ayan. Nakita ko, if I read it right, Jasmine nag-raise ng hand. Ayan.
Ganun din po sa sagot ni Miss Walmay po.
Okay, thank you. How about you, Russell? May hinihintay ako. Wala pa nakakuha.
Ma'am, yung mag-a-ask po ng kung sino po yung may alam ay makapagbigay po ng suggestions. Siguro, yun ba?
Ayan, thank you, Russell. Wala pa din nakakakuha. Sino pang gusto mag-try? So, lahat ng sagot nyo, definitely it's true. You can ask for help. Sino nakakaalam? Pwedeng patulong. Baka naman, di ba? Wait, may nagbaba ng hand. Ayan, well, May, do you want to try again? Go ahead.
Ano po? Ask for guidance po or magpapag-guide.
Okay, pwede din. Pero hindi pa din eh. Ayan. Sino pa? Yes, Minerva.
Ma'am, ano po? Hello? Audible yes. Po ba ako?
Audible ka. Loud and clear.
Ano po? Siguro po yung, can you give me an idea how to solve this problem using Java?
Ayan, pwede din idea. Help, idea, guidance, kung sino nakakalam. Pero hindi pa din. Sino pa gusto mag-try? Wala pa rin nakakuha nung pwedeng i-caption. Yes, Richie.
For me po, ma'am, is ano po? Pwede naman po siyang, pwede niya po siyang pag-aralan if kung mag-search po siya. Pwede po siyang gumawa ng sarili niyang ano. Like po, sali po siya magtanong is try niya po siyang mag-search sa website po upang matulungan po siya rin. Hindi lang po sa pagtanong po sa iba.
Paano? Kung wari, di ba, nag-search siya. E di, paano niya nagagawin yung caption niya? Pag kuwari, nag-search nga siya, tapos ipopost niya na, paano yung caption niya? Ayan. If nagsasalita ka, nakamute ka, Richie.
Ano po, for me po is, kung papalta po ng caption is, what I can do for this data, what I can do for using this Java. Yun lang po.
Paano kung wari, kung nahihirapan kayo construct siya in English, kung wari Tagalog, paano kung wari, ika-caption mo siya ng Tagalog, din ba kailangan English? Pero sabi mo, 'di ba, magse-search muna. So, pag anong pwede niyang ilagay or improve sa caption kung nakapag-search nga siya. Malapit ka na doon sa sagot.
Ano po,
kaya mo 'yan.
Paano po siya?
Sige lang.
Ano may, alam ko na po. Ano po, ay, ma'am, nakalimutan ko pa.
Okay lang yan. Ano, sirit na ba kayo, guys? Let me know. Sirit na? Sirit na? Okay. Bigay kayo ng thumbs up na malaki kung sirit na kayo. Sa React. Aba, may nag-raise. Oh. Yes, Jamil. Gusto pa mag-try? Go lang. Ayan. Ikaw sasalita ka, nakamute ka. Ayan. Hello, Jamil. Are you still with us? Or thumbs up yan. Ayan. Paano ko ba makikita kung nag-react kayo? Ayan.
Can you try again? Like, give me a thumbs up kung sirit na or kung may gusto pa mag-try before we proceed.
Hello? Okay, yes.
Ayan, medyo choppy ka, pero go lang. Okay na? Sirit na?
Okay, basta.
Hello?
Basta ho kami kasi mga parte, kasama ho yung mga sabi ho. Ay, garto ha.
Sayo. Ayan, feeling ko, let me know if my internet is good kasi minsan di ko alam kung ako yung choppy. So let me know, do you guys have any other answers or should we proceed? All good? Sa mga nakakamera, thumbs up or sa mga hindi, react? Let me know. Okay pa ba kayo dyan? Parang siguro na, sabi, atcha, bakit naman ang hirap ng tanong mo? Ayan, wait lang. Okay, all good. Wala akong nakikitang thumbs up. I don't know if it's just the Zoom, the Teams, or anybody would like to try. Ayan, thank you for that thumbs up. So we will proceed. So the answer that I was looking for is, tama, help, pwedeng guide me, pwedeng idea. Instead na sabi mong, uy, sagutin mo naman to. Kasi that's not a good way of asking for help is to ask directly for the answer or sagot. Tama. Tama yung mga sagot nyo. Pero how we can improve this sa nagpost is, tulad ng sabi ni Russell, is to search muna. Diba, we are privileged and we heavily rely on the web, pero we're not doing proper use of it. So, the correct approach kung hihingi kayo ng tulong sa internet or sa community in Facebook is to do it first on your own. Sabi ni Russell, mag-search muna. Pag na-search mo na, pero parang alam mo na yung sagot kung paano i-convert tong flowchart na to at gumawa ng function using Java, pero hindi ka sure kung tama. Kasi diba tulad ng sabi nyo, hindi lahat ng nasa internet is totoo or factual. That's why pwede kang pa rin mag-post. How are you going to change your caption? You can say that, hi, I'm working on an assignment using Java or kung Tagalog. Pwede po bang pa-check ng sagot ko? Ito po kasi yung pinapagawa sa amin. It's always a good practice to do it on your own first before you ask for help and ask for validation or ipapa-check nyo. Hindi, it's not a good practice or a good attitude to directly post it without doing any effort. As students, meron na tayong meron na kayong ChatGPT, 'di ba? Pero I dito sa San Diego, dito sa US, lagi akong na-attend ng mga events ng mga CTOs, ng mga AI professionals, and talagang sinasabi nila, ang AI nandiyan na matagal na 'yan. Nauso na lang 'yan, nauso na kasi yung ChatGPT kaya nagmukhang fresh in the ears and the eyes of the people. But what they don't know is that these type of generative AI, they learn as they go. They're not always, you cannot always rely on it 100%. Kasi it's studying data sets, diba? Later, magkakaroon kayo ng session about it and you would understand AI in its use. Pero on this slide, even though we have this opportunity and advantage compared to our ancestors with technology, let's also give value to ourselves. Kasi hindi natin tinutulungan yung sarili natin kung we heavily rely on technology. Technology is there to help us, but technology, hindi dapat tayo maging alipin. Kasi hindi tayo matututo, hindi kayo matututo. Oo nga, naghingi ka ng tulong. Hindi ka nag-try, pero may sumagot. So yun yung pinasa mo sa teacher nyo. Kagraduate ka, natuto ka nga ba? That's the sad thing about being an information system student. Kagraduate ka, pero hindi mo binigyan ng value yung sarili mo. That's why your professors and teachers are helping you to take into practice to use technology, not let technology use you. That is the purpose of this slide. Ayan, very good guys for trying. But again, the caption, itatry niya muna bago niya mag-post. Walang masama mag-post. Walang masama sa ginawa niya. Pero yung caption and yung approach niya is something that this person needs to improve on. I think nakita niya yung name niya. Anyway,
Kaya naging malungkot tuloy si Sir Tim Berners-Lee dahil dun sa post, no, nag-post dun sa IT Philippines. Yun, nakasimangot na tuloy siya. Kanina, di ba, nakangiti siya sa mga picture. Kasi sabi niya nga, kaya niya nga daw ginawa ang World Wide Web is to give universal access. Sabi niya dun sa quote niya, is to give opportunity for people to have a voice. But not all people are using its main purpose. Nalungkot tuloy. Pinalungkot niya si Sir Tim Berners-Lee. Ayan, and again, it gives us an opportunity to connect, to communicate, and to have these wireless connections through our devices by using the web. Ayan, don't worry, we're almost at the end. And at the same time, although tulad nga ng sabi ng Deloitte, diba, on their study, it shows in the bar graph na hirap mag-adjust ng older generation, so we guide them. We give them this understanding kung bakit kailangan nilang gamitin itong smart technologies kasi mas mapapadali at mapapagana ang buhay nila. Although minsan challenging talaga i-encourage ang older generation to use our smartphones, but there's a lot of accessible applications that are suited for them so they can appreciate yung ating applications today. Ayan, and this is where the challenges come in. First, then, tulad na sabi niyo, danger for the children, walang filter, can get too addicting. And with World Wide Web, medyo nagiging tongue twister siya, one of the challenges is there is an overload and excess of information. And we have this term called excessive server resource usage. Tulad nga nang sabi ng isa sa inyo, this can also give a detrimental impact to the environment by using a lot of resources, such as servers, a lot of hardware, a lot of wires, diba? Kasi even though we have the cloud right now, it still works on a physical server. Ayan. And paano nagkakaroon na excessive server resource usage is dahil sa server, diba, meron tayong CPU. Ano ibig sabihin ng CPU? Anyone? What does CPU stand for? Nako, pag hindi nyo na alam yung sagot dito, nandito yung prof nyo ngayon. Ayan, what the CPU? Yes, Richie.
Central Processing Unit po.
Ayan, very good. So, CPU stands for Central Processing Unit. Ayan, and that can be thought like the brain of the machine. And almost any request of the server has to deal with its going to require time from the CPU to process that type of request. Ayan, that the user wants. So, kaya nagkakaroon ng excessive server resource usage is because yung level ng CPU processing sa website dapat minimal lang compared with your local desktop CPU activities. Although it's everything is being communicated through the client, through the server, with our different protocols. Dito nagkakaroon ng impact sa server and yung CPU intensive website usage na nagkakaroon ng a lot of excessive amount of CPU processing time also could affect the traffic. An example of this is kung meron kang isang WordPress site na may mga plugins na naka-enable, na walang form of caching, definitely magkakaroon ng or magko-consume ng around 1 second of CPU time. Ayan. Tapos magiging mabagal, matagal para ma-process siya and mabalik dun sa website visitor or user yung full HTML code para ma-display sa screen nila. So, ayan. So, it could depend then sa required processing time from your website on how much information does it need to process and load and display on the user's end. So, that is an example of the one of the challenges of the World Wide Web is danger. Second is filter difficulty, which is the inability to filter and prioritize information. Ayan. And one of the solutions for that type of challenge is to create a filter. Maraming examples. Meron dito tayong non-technical sa left and technical sa right. Diba, meron tayong child na gumagamit ng internet. Ayan. And then, syempre, meron tayong ways on how the parents or how the information systems or IT professionals can filter that so that the child or yung bata hindi nila basta-basta ma-access yung inappropriate or websites. Mga ayun. So on the lower right side, we have
how it can be filtered. Meron tayong URL filtering na tinatawag on how they can filter that type of content for the children. Ayan. Okay, let's talk about World Wide Web and the dangers of filtering and child restricted content. Sino dito ang may kilala kay Tony Fowler? Anybody know who Tony Fowler is? Raise your hand. Ayan. Nakakakita ako sa mga camera niya ng reaction. We're going to talk about her today. That is related to the World Wide Web. Ayan. Alam kong Marites din kayo. So, let me know. Raise your... diba, nakangiti dyan. Raise your hand if you know her. Walang nakakalam sa kanya? Ayan. Pwede ba nabuhayan kayo? Kanina parang, atya, ang dami mong sinasabing technical. Ayun, sinabi kong Tony Fowler, nabuhayan kayo ng dugo. Ayan. Let's talk about her today. So, Tony Fowler is one of the known influencers in the Philippines for her content. She started with creating vlogs and then prank videos. She grew, she became so famous. She even created a music video. She has 2 music videos and I listened to her music video. When it came out, nung nakita ko na Spotify siya, on repeat siya, inaano ko siya sa utak ko paulit-ulit. Siyempre, age appropriate na ako, pero anyone and even a child can listen to that and access that. Madaming nagbash, sabi dito sa comment, she never disappoints when it comes to disappointing, sabi ni the commenter. Sabi ng isa, as an influencer, you have the responsibility of your own contents. It doesn't matter if you are a vlogger, a content producer, an influencer, a social media manager, ang dami niyang sinabi, whoever you are on the internet. So kung sino ka man. So you are responsible for the next generation to see how our current culture is being presented to them in the future. Sabi ni Rizal, ang kabataan, tama ba yung sabi ko si Rizal ba nagsabi yun, ang pag-asa ng bayan, which is totoo. Although she gave a defense, she said that all her, yung mga hindi appropriate sa bata is, makikita mo doon, eto screenshot ko sa isa sa video niya, age-restricted video. So sabi niya, in her defense, the content that she published online in the eyes of the public is age-restricted. So ibig sabihin, in an information systems point of view, meron ng filter. Nung bago pa pinabish ni Tony Fowler yung kanyang video, ayan, I believe lahat naman siguro kayo dito ay over 18, di ba? Her MPL and MNM, in technical logic, it's already filtered by the YouTube site. Although we are aware that minsan it's hindi na kaya din i-monitor ng parents yung content na dinadigest ng bata. I know that for a fact because when I was 12 years old, I was able to access Omegle. And Omegle is not a site for me at my age, I was 12, but I was able to access it. And I was able to see things that I'm not supposed to see in Omegle. And up until now, Omegle is still accessible. That is an example of one of the websites. So even though in Tony's defense, it's an age-restricted video, with the internet and accessibility that we have right now, we still cannot guarantee that it is safe for children to go to the internet. Kaya may YouTube Kids na tinatawag. Eh, paano atya kung hindi na YouTube Kids yung pinsan ko, pero pang YouTube na siya, pero hindi niya pwede makita yung content ni Tony Fowler kasi nga bata pa din siya. Kaya hindi na siya pwede mag-YouTube Kids. So, yun yung questions na meron tayo when we access the web. An example of this is this one, this age-restricted filtering. It's not always reliable because we also have to consider how that user or that child accesses the web. Ayan. So, this is one of the controversies of her content. I don't watch her content anymore. If you know, she has this like new content every week. Pero kasi this is an example of how filtering and how web, the challenges of the web is experiencing right now through this filtering in YouTube. Ayan, dami ko sinabi. I want to hear your thoughts in this slide. Based on what you learned about how filtering is a challenge in the World Wide Web, what are your thoughts on this one? Anyone? Ayan. Anyone would like to share their thoughts or after what you have heard? Yes, Apple.
Ma'am, di ba po, ano yun? Di ba po sinabi niya kanina yung about filtering?
Yes.
Napakahirap nga po, ma'am, dahil nga po, hindi po lahat ng ina ay lagi pong kasama itong anak at namomonitor po yung kanyang anak. Kaya po, yan po, ang sinabi po dyan sa comment ay yung may responsibilidad pa din po yung nag-post, which is si Mami Tony, dahil nga po, siya po yung nag-produce, kumbaga po, parang ganun. So, siya, may responsibilidad po talaga siya. So, para po sa akin talaga, ang sama dahil, syempre po, pag nakita po ng bata, akala nila normal lang yun, parang ganun po mo.
Yes, good answer, Apple. And definitely, hindi naman lahat ng bata ay pares mag-isip. My experience when I went to Omegle and I saw a lot of inappropriate things on my age, I was 12, that site should only be accessed by 12 and up. Hindi lahat ng bata is pares mag-isip kung paano kung nakita yung site na yun, which is not to copy it. Diba tulad ng concern mo, Apple, sabi mo baka i-imitate nung bata yung ginagawa or yung pinapakita ni Tony Fowler or nung content creator. And my point of view back then, I know it's a bad thing. It feels so uncomfortable going on that website. Kasi if you haven't heard of Amigo, it's like online platform to communicate with other people outside or globally. You can have chat, you can have video. But yung image kasi na Amigo, naging bad na siya. Maraming malicious people in the web na din. So, point of view ko noon, syempre you can select randomly who you want to chat with. So, dun ko finifilter. Merong website, merong tag option si Omegle para kung sino lang yung gusto kong kausapin. Kung wari, Pinoy. Nakita ko doon Pinoy. Kung wari, age group ko, ganyan. So, that's the purpose of the web, is to help filter the user kung ano lang yung content na gusto nilang makita. Although at the same time, may point din sa second comment, you are responsible as a content creator to post what your audience should appropriately see or view or consume na binibigay mong content. At the same time, this is an open discussion kasi there's a lot of point of views and every point of view is valid. But as information system students and professionals in the future, this is also a challenge for you to be able to come up with a solution so that we can help itong mga younger generation to filter their content. Kasi as you can see, it's evident that there's still a problem with TikTok, with Facebook and YouTube. Hirap pa din eh, yung mga professionals to be able to filter that content. At the same time, if you're going to think about it, what if that child is using their parents' phone? Siyempre yung phone ni mami, hindi naman naka-filter yan. Kasi si mami may-ari, siya yung adult. Paano kung walang sariling cellphone yung anak? So, ang daming reasons, ang daming loopholes, ang daming pwedeng maging nangyayari para makalusot yung bata to be able to access that content. So, this is an open-ended question for you all as information systems professional in the future on how we can resolve this challenge in the World Wide Web. Ayan. Aside from Apple, anybody else? At least last one before we proceed. Ayan. Very good answer. Last one. Meron bang ano dyan? Ay, hindi. Ate Acha, tama yung ginawa ni Mami Tony Fowler. Gusto ko yun dahil sinabi mo Mami. Ayan. Diba ang tawag sa kanya, Mami Tony Fowler? So, meron ba ditong sinasabing tama yung ginawa niya? Or meron ditong agree din sa sinabi ni Apple? Ayan. Anybody else? Last one before we move on. We're almost done. Don't worry. Ayan. Anyone? Last one? Yes, Gabriel.
Yan nga po. So, sinabi po ni Apple po na hindi po lahat pare-parehas mag-isip po lahat ng mga bata. Ito pong age-restricted videos sa YouTube ay may question po at nagre-require ng email address. Yung question po yun, are you 18 or above? Madali pong pindutin yung yes, kahit po hindi. Alam ko po, madami po sa mga bata po ngayon, pinipindot yung yes kahit dapat hindi po talaga nila pindutin po. Kaya po, yun nga po. Sa, mas maganda po kung may mas magagawa, may magagawang bagong design ng pagre-restrict kesa yung yes or no question lang po na yun.
Ayan. Thank you, Gabriel. Very good. So, as an information system student, naisip mo ang one ways to improve it is to make it more complex for the user para ma-identify niya. Diba, meron nga tayong, are you a robot? Diba, mga ganun example of other samples of questions to be able to validate if the user is really 18. Yes, Apple. Would like to add more? Ayan.
Ma'am, i-add lang po ako. Ang akin po ay hindi po lahat ng problems or issues ay dapat po insinisisi sa web po. Dahil pong mismong tao na po mismo ang nagawa ng problema or ikasira po ng parang yung mundo po na ginagawa online.
Yes, ayan. Very good. Thank you, Apple. Kasi at the end of the day, Tony Fowler or Mommy Tony Fowler, it's her. We cannot control the content that she posts. And if we know that for a fact, as users, di ba, it's up to us or for the parents who are able to access her content is to be able to restrict that child into viewing her content further or in the future. Kasi we know her. We know her personality. She doesn't stop posting what she wants to post. And that's being a content creator. Content creators have a control of the content that they want regardless of what the people may say about their content. Diba? May good influencers, may bad influencers, content creators. They have control of their content. And we also have control of the content that we want to consume. Very good answers, guys. All right. Last three challenges. Almost there. We have user management. Too much users in the web can also be a challenge due to overload. Ayan. And large number of users. Tulad nga ng sabi natin, mayroon tayo excessive server resource usage. And quality control is definitely a challenge when it comes to data management. Not only that, there are a lot of data to manage. There can also be data redundancy, as in paulit-ulit, na nagtitake or nagko-consume ng space or resources in the web. Alright, tulad nga nito, diba? Tulad na sabi nyo, aside from a lot of resources, there can also be an environmental impact that we can have to consider. Ayan! So, a while ago, I asked you, bakit natin kailangan gumawa ng programs or applications? But, we're almost at the end of our discussion. So, my follow-up questions is, if we should, if you have a reason as to why we should, we need to create one, should we still create one? Given that based on the Forbes data, there's almost 2 billion websites that are being created, created overall, and there are less than 300 million websites created every day. Do you think as information systems professional right now and once you graduate, do you think you should still need to create programs or applications? Yes or no? Kung yes, why? Kung no, why? Ayan. Meron bang both? Let me know. Malapit na tayo matapos, guys. Ayan. Let me, before someone else volunteers, I'm seeing a handful of recognizable names here. I want to hear from other people naman this time. How about Al John or Al John? Ayan. Sige, susunod kitang tawagin Jella May. Pero how about Al John? If you can unmute your mic, please. Again, the question is, now that we all know that there's a reason for us to create one, or there is or was a reason why we need to create programs, should we still create more, considering that there are a lot of websites that are being created every day? Ayan. If you can unmute, let me know. While waiting for Al John, I'm going to call someone else. Ayan. We're still waiting for you. Ayan. Yes, Precious. Very good. What's your answer?
Yes. Yung kapag po gumraduate ng isang IS students, pwede pa rin po siya gumawa ng programs and applications kasi po ang internet naman po or World Wide Web ay mayroon laging room for improvement. So, binibigyan yung users ng options kung anong gagamitin, kung saan gagamitin, paano gagamitin, and may mga responsibilities din po na nakaakipat sa kanila as a graduate po.
Ayan, very good answer. How about the others? How about, ayan, how about Nina? Nina Sarmiento, if you can unmute your mic and let me know your answer to this question, should we still create programs or applications? Tulad ng sabi ni Precious, there's still a lot of things that we need to improve. Do you agree? Yes, ayan.
For me po ay, kasi sobrang dami na po programs and applications ngayon, sa panahon ngayon. And I think, yun na po.
Ayun, sorry, hindi ko masyado narinig. I only heard there are a lot of websites that are created. What would be your answer to the question if we would still need? Kailangan pa rin ba gumawa ng websites? Kahit marami na?
No, ma'am.
Why?
Kasi nga po, sobrang dami na po ng mga programs and applications and parang pag dumami pa po ng dumami ay parang mas dadami pa po yung mga bad effects po.
Oh, ayan. Thank you. So, that's her point of view. So, meron tayong yes, meron tayong no. Meron pa bang ibang gustong sumagot? That's interesting. I mean, it's true in a way that we would be needing to use more resources that could potentially give a bad effect to the environment. But at the same time, the yes answer has a point. We still need to improve other systems. Anybody else? Yes, Apple.
Ma'am, may point po yung kanina po, yung yes or no. Tapos ma'am, parang dun sa no po, parang ang supporting ideas po na pwede ko pong maibigay din. Yung i-improve ma'am yung mga existing programs and application for us to be able ma'am na makahabol po sa trend. Yung ganun po.
Ayan, thank you. How about you, Jelome? Ayan. If you're speaking, you're on mute. Yes. Ayan. Let me know anybody else before we proceed. Yes. Ayan. Nag-on siya ng cam. Ayan. Are you going to add more? Yes, Richie.
What's the question?
Oh, the question is on this slide. Should we still create programs or applications kahit marami ng website na ginawa ngayon?
Para po sa akin is yes po. Kasi po, programs or applications po is like ano po, pinaka important part po siya sa website. Kasi po pagka ang pagano po ng application or program is like po pag-update or pag-evolve po ng isang website. Kaya po tayong gumagawa po ng mga panibagong application or programs is para po mapakita natin yung mga bagong updates, bagong labas po, mga bagong pinapalabas po nila na ano, like po ng Facebook po. Nag-update po sila ng features. Tulad po ng mga chat GPT or mga AI po. Kaya po mas dumami po silang ginawa ng program kasi po yung nauso pong chat GPT rin yan is makakatulong po. Kaya po sila nagkakagawa ng bago is like, dinadagdagan po nila mga bagong updates or mga ganun po.
Ayan, thank you for that. So, lahat ng point of view niyo or yung answers niyo are valid. It's true that we shouldn't create more applications or programs if it's a redundant website. Ibig sabihin, meron na existing, tas gumawa ka na naman, it's you're not making proper use of the resources or sayang. What the point of the yes answer means is that we still need to create existing information systems or applications in order to improve them. So both answers are correct is that we say no to create if we would be wasting resources, but we should create or update, yun yung tamang term, improve, update, innovate existing applications or programs that we have. Very good, guys. Okay, let's proceed. Ayan. Last part of my presentation is the trends in the World Wide Web. So, ito na, where we have asked the when, why, what. Nandito na tayo sa where. The last part of our presentation for today is the trends. Ano ba yung mga pwede nating gawin? Ano na ba yung mga uso ngayon at pwede nating gawin with World Wide Web? First and foremost, we have IoT or Internet of Things integration. So, meron na tayong mga smartphones, smartwatches, smart houses, commercial machines. Meron ng, if you go to a fast food restaurant, di ba meron tayong Jollibot? Nakalimutan ko kung saan yun. Pero I did that example before in one of my presentations. May Jollibot na. Instead of a server going up to the customer to serve their meal, there's already a robot with IoT technology that can bring your food from the counter to your table. Ayan. Or smart home appliances. Ako, I used to have a traditional watch, but now I am wearing a smart watch because mas nakakatulong siya sa health ko. Could track my stress levels, my yung paglakad ko, etc., and my sleeping pattern, which is really helpful. Ayan, and I can access it on my mobile phone. Next, we have IT and machine learning. This will be one of the topics that you'll be encountering more. But with World Wide Web, ang connection niya with AI and ML is it helps automate tasks. Tinatanong nyo or nawawonder kayo, acha, pag graduate ba kami, magkakaroon pa rin ba kami ng trabaho kasi may mga robot na, may mga AI ML na, may ChatGPT na, na kayang-kayang gawin yung trabaho ng programmer. Yes, hindi tayo mawala ng trabaho as tech students. Why? Because technology is only there to guide us and help us. Help make our jobs easier or professions easier as tech professionals. And in the view of an information systems, AI and ML will only help you to, they will be focusing on mundane tasks. Ibig sabihin, ang gagawin, ang trabaho ng AI at ML sa field ng information systems professional is sila ang gagawa ng mga paulit-ulit na tasks na ginagawa nyo para makapag-focus kayo sa mas importanteng tasks or major tasks that would need a human perception of decision making and personalized experiences sa inyong mga products. Siyempre, hindi naman wala pang capability ang AI and ML to create business decisions that would be needing more analysis when it comes to that point. Some do, some do not. It depends on the type of product that you are working on or managing. Ayan. Number three, ito yung example ng AI and ML. An example of this one is, ayan, customer service AI and virtual assistants. Diba? Kung pagpupunta kayo, kung wari sa Shopee, nakalimutan ko na ako sino sumagot nun. Kung mahilig ka mag-online shopping at meron kang product na nireceive, bumili ka ng t-shirt para sa'yo, pero kaso siya sa aso mo at hindi sa'yo. So, magka-customer service ka. Instead na tatawag ka ng agent, meron ka ng customer service AI. At na-filter na niya at kaya niya na nang sagutin yung mga concerns mo at i-help ka. Kung wari sabihin mo sa kanya na yun nga, mali yung shirt size na natanggap mo, dun sa sinabi mo, alam na niya agad kung ano yung next step para ma-solve yung concern mo. An example that I'm showing in my screen is an internet customer service AI named Anna. Sometimes meron din silang persona na tinatawag to be able to identify the AI technology. Ayan. Next, we have number three, Web 3.0 or the decentralized web. So what Web 3.0, di ba kanina na-encounter natin si Web 2.0. The purpose of Web 2.0 is to have a user-generated content. The purpose of Web 3.0 is to create a decentralized internet where users have more control over their data and online experiences. Going back to Mami Tony Fowler na napaka-favorite nating example for today, we have Web 3.0 to be able to tackle this
concern of controlling our data and online experiences. So these platforms will challenge the hegemony, if that's the correct way to pronounce it, of centralized tech corporations by enhancing security, privacy, and data ownership. Ayan, decentralized finance or DeFi and non-fungible tokens or NFTs will redefine digital economies and alter online transactions. Kasi diba, another concern of the web is our privacy, cybersecurity. It's really important for us to be able to know how we can protect our data. Any information that we put on the internet is out there. It's out on the public. Diba? Ayan. Ayan. And we also have a community if you're interested to learn more on how Web 3.0 works. We have a community called Web3 Philippines. And you can see or learn a lot more from them if you're interested in their community, how they would be able to create a Web3 empowered Philippines. Sabi dun sa caption nila, ayan. Number 4, 5G and beyond. Most of our smartphones have 5G capability to be able to have faster speeds, lower latency, and larger capacity when processing and transferring data. Ayan, it's 100 times faster than 4G, allowing for lightning fast downloads para makapag-stream na kayo ng favorite K-drama nyo or malaki ng favorite episode nyo sa YouTube and smooth streaming. When I was in my third year college during the pandemic, I have created a small research about 5G as part of our networks and communications course. I have a video of that on my YouTube channel and I explained how 5G is different from other networks and how it affects other people. A part of my small research there is may nagpakamatay dahil parang yung point of 5G nila is very different sa purpose nito. Parang kasi syempre pandemic and it has affected a lot of people mentally, and at the same time it was the emergence of 5G networks back then. Tingin nila deadly ang 5G, and I explained that yung mga na-research ko in that small paper. It's on my YouTube channel, Introduction to Networks. So I did talk about 5G networks. And if you're interested in that. And then number 4, second to the last, we have AR or augmented reality and VR virtual reality. Our relation niya sa World Wide Web is to have more advancements. Right now, we are on Teams, and we Teams has created an AR-VR feature wherein they have avatars that you can use. Madalas namin ito ginagamit sa work right now in the company that I work for. The company that I work for is based in New York. I am in the US and I work from home online. And when we meet each other in Teams, dati we use Zoom. Now, nag-migrate na kami fully in Teams and makukulit yung mga katrabaho ko. Instead of showing their faces on the camera, they use avatars. So if your account or school account or Teams has that feature, you can explore that. But meron ng mga ganyan. Here's an example of an AR type of picture in Teams where you can communicate without showing your true face. Ini-imitate niya lang yung facial expressions mo through an avatar. And last is progressive web applications. As you can see, based on the history going to the present of the improvement and evolution of World Wide Web, we can now access the web through our phones. And an example of that is the PWA or Progressive Web Apps, where you can access your applications offline. A PWA is an application software delivered through the web using web technologies like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and WebAssembly. And if you want to learn more about that, meron din akong tutorial on how to create your first PWA. And meron din akong explanation on that. I was able to create that video with PWA Pilipinas. Meron din tayong community for Filipinos who are enthusiasts in progressive web applications. So if you want to try to create your first PWA, you can watch that video on my channel. Ayan. So we already answered the question why we create, should we still create, and if using the web is good or bad. And based on your answers, you definitely, hindi ko na kailangan tanungin ulit, you already know the answer to this question. And I hope you learned a lot.
Ayan, thank you for your time. I know it has been almost 2 hours akong non-stop talking about World Wide Web. And this will give you an idea further on how UI UX design, blockchain technology, AIML has emerged throughout the years. It's because of these technologies like World Wide Web, they have their purpose is interconnected with one another on how we'll be able to access and have convenience in using the web. Ayan, thank you for your time, everyone. And let me know what you want to learn about next by scanning this QR code. Although we do not have a chat, I will be sharing this link later to one of the organizers so you can let me know kung ano pa yung gusto nyo matutunan. And let me know yung feedback nyo on how I did in today's talk. Ayan, and if you have any further questions after this one, you can leave it on my feedback form. I'll send it shortly. Or you can start scanning this QR code if you have your phones. Ayan. And you can, if you want to learn more, I also create my computer science and IT and IS related content on my YouTube channel, Atsha Abe. I am on, you can connect with me on LinkedIn, Athena Atsha Abe. I'm on Facebook and YouTube, Atsha Abe. I'm also on Instagram and X, dati Twitter, ngayon X na. Ayan, at Aliafe Abe. Aside from creating tech content, I also do challenges, entertainment, tech, and I do vlogging. Ayan. And if you have your other friends or in different universities, I'm also open to other speaking engagements. And I also teach anywhere around web dev, web design, cybersecurity, data analytics, etc. Ayan. So you can always invite me if you want me to talk about another topic. Ayan, guys. Thank you so much for your time. And I'm open to your questions.